Boosting. What boosting is a little bit similar to the backing, but the difference is the embedding. All the voters classify our peers. Nobody has superior than the other. But the boosting is a iterative process, and the later classifier is built on the wisdom of the previous classifier. That means I'm going to improve the previous classifier. How to improve it? You just need to do a little bit of analysis to find the weakness and the deficiency. For example, because you have the test case. If this consistently misclassified a particular a subset of data, you just give more weight on that subset, or you can manipulate it in two different ways. One way is you purposely, intentionally select this wrong classifier more frequently. You make it into like 10, 10, 10. If this is one wrong, you make it 4 times. They're going to have more weight in the training. Just like I teach the one you have difficulty to understand the more frequently. That's one way. Another way is in the algorithm, for example, for the artificial neural network, you have the weight. I can give more penalty for those errors. And the one you correct yourself, because the penalty is heavy, you're going to, your algorithms reduce the error, right? You're going to give this more attention to get this right instead of that. So the boosting is the most successful idea because they can always give more weight in the next round for those misclassified cases. And they give less weight to this correctly classified in the next round. Then the next round will be improving the deficiency of the previously classified. But in the end, they're going to weight all the classifiers according their credibility, the credential. Means the low error rate, then merge them together. Basically, just like you do teamwork, you all come from different domain, and this project is always interdisciplinary, and you're going to all vote, but your vote are not equal. You trust the people who are in computer science for his idea about this algorithm. You trust the people in their domain about this domain inside. How do you select? That's how it works. It's all come from human intelligence. Make sense? Now look at this in the boosting. The easy way, if I consistently make this wrong, and then the next round, I'm going to make this 2 times, 3 times. If I still make a mistake, when I sample it 5 times. Can you see? Until I know the penalty is too heavy for me to not get this right. Right? That's the easy way. That's like backing. And the other function is the error is always use this epsilon I is called the error of the classifier I. You have 1, 2, all the way to T classifiers. That means of T models. In each model, you estimate the error rate by the testing data. And then you come up with this epsilon I, which is the error, and this function is like this. You can see, if that's zero, and that's infinity, right? That's impossible, no error. But if it's half, that's 1. Can you see it? Half is 1. Why? Because that's 1/2 over 1/2 is 1, right? Well, logarithm 1 is 0, right? Are you with me? See, 1/2 over 1/2 is 1. Logarithm 1 is 0. That's why 1/2, you get a 0. Can you see it? But I only pick those error less than 1/2. If it's, you know, if I have 2 classes, if you are bigger than 1/2 error, why won't you? And just throw it back, you know, reset it. You cannot possibly always get 1/2. Why? Because you choose a random. You are not going to choose the same thing again. You know, if it's about one half, you just throw it away. Then as soon as this is always less than one half, can you see that this is bigger than one? This is bigger than one, this is positive, right? It's very important to note this alpha is a positive number. And then I'm going to come back to this. And this is the weight I give. The weight is given e to the negative alpha. And then if this is correct, that means because this is positive, e to the negative number is always less than 1, right? So if this is correct, last time you classified it right, I give you less weight. But the e to this is going to be bigger than 1, right? Right? And then the weight for the wrong classified is going to be bigger. And then that will be the weight, that's a normalization. It means you got all the weight normalized. So in this way, you give heavy penalty to the error and then put more weight to the wrong classified. See, the weight is always associated with the classified which you get wrong. If you get wrong, you get a heavy weight, you get right, you get a small weight, and this is going to be in the end, the assembled classified error is the weighted average of that. That's the end error. But each round, because you're doing one round after another round after another round, you need to update this by using the same formula. Idea is pretty simple. And then in the end result, in the end result, all you need is you need to maximize this total correct with a different weight. That's all. A simple idea. You need to maximize the character classified. That it can make a vote. But you're not going to get the same vote. What's the vote? This weight. This weight, remember, is associated with your error rate. The more error you have, the less weight you get when you end the vote. But when you train in, the more error you make, the more attention you get, the more likely you're going to correct it. Now, in this case, you know, this is the class, the only class and the minus class. You just think about a situation, you got the, you want to classify this, and initially you get the 1, 2, how many we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. Each of them get a 0.1 weight. That's the even distributed weight in the beginning. And then after you finish the first round, you find, you cut it here. You remember the homework exercise, you get this discrete good continuous number. I want you to use the entropy to cut it into two different bins. And that's very similar. When you do this, discretize the continuous number, it's the same as you classify based on the numerical number, right? And it depends on how many classify you want. In this case, you know the class. That's positive, that's negative. But now after the first round, because these two are wrong, you classify the wrong, I give more weight, you see? This is the alpha equal 1.9, that's e to the negative positive alpha, and then you divide by the normalized vector, that's kind of like 5 times bigger than those numbers, right? So that's just the e to this is big, but you need to divide to make the total percentage is 150. So you only need to realize this is 5 times bigger than this because you made the wrong here for this two. And then the next one, okay, you made this two right, but this wrong again. That's the second round, that's another classifier. And you made this wrong, and you recalculate the alpha, and then you're going to, in this case, made the alpha equal this, then everything kind of, you have time never put together everything right. It really depends on that. But in this way, each time you fix one problem, you focus one shortcoming, and then you merge them, give them the proper weight, they're going to overperform, each of them. That's the idea. One round, and then you do this calculation, you do it again, and then again, and then you merge them. This is a better example. But I just now give you the number. I have one and the next one. This is very simple. It's a number. The x value, that's the attribute. The attribute is from 0 to 9. I have no other thing, I just tell you 1, 2, 3 is positive, 3, 4, 5 is negative, 6 is 7, 8 is positive, and the 9 is negative. That's all I tell you. Then if I say, how are you going to train this to make it as correct as you can? Well, intuitively, if you want to each time to cut one line, you can cut it here, right? Mm. And this is positive, or this is negative. If you do this, you get the 3 wrong, right? That's the best option. You remember the entropy? You just want the maximum purity when you cut it. The highest purity you can cut is either here or here. If you do this, you have 4 wrong, right? You need to cut it where you change, either here, here, or here, right? If you do this way, you get the, let me see, that's negative, that's positive. You still throw 3 wrong, similar, but I cut it here. Then I give them all the same weight. My hypothesis is either x is bigger than my threshold, or x smaller than my threshold, just the binary tree branching tree. Each one, the first one, I give each 0.1 weight. So if I cut this equal 0.5, you know, the first one, the error rate is 0.3, because each weight is 0.13 wrong, 0.3, right? That's my error, then my alpha is 0.423648. That's the easy alpha. That's the weight I give the correct one. And that's the weight I give the wrong one. You see, the wrong one has more than double weight, right? But I need to divide the total to make it then 100%. That's normalizing. But the second round, when I normalize, can you see this heavy? This have a heavy rate. Can you see it? This correct one have small weight. My focus in this 3, right? That's wrong. Then I do the next one. I did all the calculations. I just look where I cut. If I cut between 2 and 3, that will result 3 mistake with a heavy rate. That heavy will be 0.451. That's not a good way to cut. You want to minimize the error, right, when you cut. If I cut it between 5 and 6, I got a 0.28 because I have 4 wrong. Each of the weight is 0.71 in the middle. Then I get a 4 wrong, no good. The best cut is between 8 and 9. I get only 0.21 error. That's the minimum. Here, when you change here and here. Then the second round, I'm going to cut here. When you cut here, your mistake is this 3. But this 3 have a small weight. That's 0.249, right? Then your second one will be wrong for something else. The previous wrong. In this way, because I fixed this in the second round, then the next one I cut it from here. That means the last two belongs to one class, and 9 and 10, and the rest belongs to another class. I have 3 mistakes. And then, look, the weight is this 3. Can you see? The heavy weight is this 3 because I made this wrong this time. And the first time I made this wrong, now I made this wrong. This is heavy. And then I add this 2. Can you see the weight of them depends on the error rate? This is this rate and this is this weight. And then I got the merged one. I still have 3 mistakes, by the way. And which 3 mistakes will hold between 5 and 6? And then I need to cut one more time. You remember there's a three place to change, right? The last one I cut from 5.5. Then you see 5.5 is here. And they see this is not heavy because I made this wrong in the second round, right? This one, see this is heavy, right? Then I make the third one. This is cut in where? In 5.5 in here. This is the last time. Then I got another learner. This is the two, now get this one. And this one now, you get this arrow. Add three, that's the end. Add this three with the proper way. And the one this three put together, you got no mistake. Everything's right.